ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंश ऋषभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय గీతామృత దుఃఖే నమః. హరిహి ఓం శ్రీ గురుభ్యో నమో నమః. మై బెస్ట్ విషెస్ అండ్ పరిపూర్ణ ఆశీర్వాదంస్ టు ఆల్ ద వ్యూవర్స్ ఆఫ్ శ్రీ వెంకటేశ్వర భక్తి ఛానల్. మే ద ఆల్ మైటీ శ్రీ లార్డ్ వెంకటేశ్వర బెస్టో ఆల్ కైండ్స్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాస్పరిటీ, హెల్త్, వెల్త్ అండ్ ఎటర్నల్ హ్యాపీనెస్ విత్ పరిపూర్ణ లక్ష్మీ కటాక్షంస్ టు యూ అండ్ ఎంటైర్ యువర్ ఫ్యామిలీ మెంబర్స్ అండ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. లెట్ అస్ బిగిన్ భగవద్గీత వర్డ్స్ నంబర్ 20 ఆఫ్ 10th చాప్టర్. శ్రీ భగవానువాచ అహం ఆత్మా గుడాకేశ సర్వభూతాశయ స్థితః అహమాదిశ్చ మధ్యంచ భూతానామంత ఏవ చ. భగవాన్ కృష్ణ హ్యాస్ బిగన్ టు నెరేట్ హిస్ స్వరూప అగైన్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ గ్లోరీ విచ్ ఇస్ నోన్ యాజ్ యోగ మహిమ విభూతి మహిమ యాజ్ వి సా from verse number 4 to 11. Then Arjuna had the elaborate question. In order to explore more elaborately the vibhuti of Bhagavan Krishna, now Bhagavan Krishna has given just in this verse, verse number 20 contains a short form which is going to be explored elaborately. He says, Ahamatma Gudakesha. First, the word Gudakesha to be realized properly. Gudakayaha Ishvaraha. Long back, I have told there are two meanings. One is known as Sikha. The Sikha means a style of Sikha which he had was known as Gudakesha. Gudakayaha Ivakesha. But one more meaning, one who has got victory over his sleep. But here, one who is endowed with sattva guna, sattvika nature, one who is able to overcome tamo guna and also rajo guna, who is able to be at sattva guna for length of time, for the lifetime. That's very difficult because these three gunas are keep on changing. That's the nature of maya. You have to realize there are three gunas. Three gunas alone have been spreaded as the srishti. Every object has got the form. That form differs object to object. But the characteristics of every guna, it doesn't differ. Because these gunas, they have their own rotation. Sattva guna, then rajo guna, then tamo guna. Then again, that rotation, it will keep on rotating itself. Therefore, we cannot control. You cannot have rajas too much. Rajas means you cannot become too much active for length of time. You need to have the rest. Not only you, even dinosaurs, they cannot work for a long. That is their limitation. Every body has got the limitation, every mind has got the limitation, all the objects which are existing in the creation, they do have their own limitations. That limitations differ. The sun has got a firing nature. It goes for the crores of years. Because we have the short length of time, 100 years, maximum 120 years. So within that, we cannot calculate the age of the sun. The sun also burns for the particular time period in the same way. So all the objects on the earth, they do have their own nature. But only the human being, because all other objects have become slave to these three gunas. But a human being can get victory over these three gunas. Nitya sattvastho bhava niryoga kshemavan bhava. That's what the teaching which began from the second chapter itself. If you want to get the spiritual growth in your life, you have to get the control over these three gunas. Tamoguna means a mind which always endowed with drowsiness or interested in wrongdoing. You become addict for cigarette, you become addict for alcohol, or you become addict for certain thing, you know, irritating others or spoiling your own health. Even, you know, overeating becomes a kind of weakness. The mind which is endowed with all kinds of these addictions known as the mind which is occupied by tamoguna. And rajoguna means what? The mind which, you know, boiling with the emotions, always boiling with the emotions, anger, frustrations, or jealousy, or some kind of restlessness, they don't know, and fear. So all these factors makes a person always, you know, it is equal to boiling the water, known as rajoguna. Rajasa phalam dukham. Gita very clearly will say the fruit of rajoguna is dukkha. The person seems to be overactive, and even people may worship, because in our India, I don't find these things outside. One should work, 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 work. So who works for 20 hours, he is considered a great soul. But the spiritual growth is completely different. When you are out focusing, extrovert, and endowed with, I mean, locked with lots of activities, you cannot get the inner growth. But once you are very much established with the knowledge, then you can work. Work becomes relaxed. Their boiling won't be there. That is the difference. I'm not criticizing the people who work a lot. We have to pity on them. Some of the people, you know, they open the shop on the festival days even, because they become addicted for that. People will say, no, wow, so how hard work he does for his family. The mind has the expectations of this kind of words, you know. We live and give the priority and importance for others' comings. The spiritual person should not get addicted to this kind of things. Therefore, this rajoguna becomes a overload for our system. Therefore, one should be very much aware. Medam hitam medyam, that we have seen already. Now, Arjuna, though he was a yodha, yodha means a person, one who goes always with battle, means who is the great fighter, and who also able to control these other two gunas. Therefore, gudakayaha ishvaraha. He becomes ishvaraha, owner of tamas and rajas. That's what the meaning of these words. Then, sarva bhuta shayasthitaha aham atma. Big word. I am the soul of all the hearts which is in the creation. So what does Bhagavan means? He says, I am the Nirguna Swarupa. See, when he explains about his nature, he always does this Nirguna Swarupa Jnanam. As I told you, a building needs to have a foundation. This is the proper foundation. Chaitanya Swarupa. This Chaitanya Swarupa means what? The nature of our consciousness. The nature of consciousness means a consciousness doesn't have any nature, but consciousness itself, it is endowed with ananda. Therefore, the nature word is used. This verse, from 20th verse onwards up to 38th verse, Bhagavan is going to explain in different way of his glories. Now, long back he explained, long back means verse number 4 to 11, he explained the nature of yoga and mahima. Now he is going to give the examples, those examples by which we can improve ourselves, called alambanam. So every example which he is going to give, those examples can be picked for the meditation and fixed as an object for the meditation. That's what the glory is. You have to have the different perception. Now he is not teaching a new thing, but he is sophisticating the things which are taught earlier. We have to be very careful. Therefore, we should not expect something new. So already which is being taught, that is nourished now. That nourishment is nothing but the assimilation for us. You have to enjoy, because once you are clear about the nature of the Ishvara, there are three kinds of natures which are said, you know, from the 7th chapter, 7th, 9th and 10th chapter also he concluded. The first stage of understanding of Ishvara, the second stage of understanding of Ishvara, the second stage of understanding of Ishvara as the world, Ishvara has become the world, that is explored as the Mahima, as the Yogam. Mahima means glory. Every human being, we have the strength, we have the capacity to live our life, to think about the nature, but some of us are overpowered and they become like Almighty. They are able to think a lot, like Aryabhatta, who could see all the planets, you know, without any equipments. Now we do have lots of equipments, but still we are struggling to find the name of the planets and the nature of the planets. We are not able to conclude what they are, what the natures they belong to. But Aryabhatta has done lots of work. And there is mathematician Ramanuja. My God, he was the king of the mathematics. And all the rishis who found Upanishads, they are, you know, they could reach, they could read the subtlety and the reality of the nature. So everything was possible, because when you travel through inside, if you travel through the indriyas, you cannot see more, you cannot understand more. Any object, if I bring the lotus, if I ask what is this, you can say, this is the lotus flower, Swamiji. That is marvelous. Do you know? So why it is red in color? Because that is the nature of this lotus. But some of other lotus are white in color. Maybe that's the nature. No, what makes, what brings the color? Then you should become botany student. Even botany students will give more technical terms, and that also understanding goes up to a particular level. Beyond that you cannot. But here he talks about the cause. That cause is explained as the practical way of living. Now these examples and understanding is the life we can live, because we can imply or the implementation of the knowledge which was given earlier by Krishna. That's what is going to begin. Now first, he is going to narrate the nature of the Chaitanya in these words. Then from next words, he is going to talk about Vibhuti in three kinds of way. Ikhaloka Vibhuti, Paraloka Vibhuti, Purana Loka Vibhuti. Vibhuti means glorious. The glories of this world, the creation, the glories of Surga, Surgadi Lokas. What is Surgadi Lokas? The Airavada, the white elephant exists with Indra. So we are not able to see the white elephant here. And the Kalpataru which exists in Indra Loka, it is not seen here. Only Ganga came from there to the earth because of the effort of Bhagiratha. There are loka now still. Therefore, Paraloka Vibhuti and Purana Loka. Purana also explains lots of characters, lots of incidents, lots of stories. Are they history? Maybe, may not be. That's not our problem. So one of my students, he came and asked, Swamiji, do you know exactly where Mahabharata happened? Then I said, of course, in India. Why? No, exactly, I would like to know where Dharmaputra was born. Then I said, see, Rama was born, everybody could accept, still is going on. Okay, you need not get confused. Just you follow the message, you get the message out of those stories. That is enough. No, we need to find. Yes, we need to find. That's the job of other people. There are people, they will find. But when you want to get the spiritual growth, don't go outside, towards outside. Gross evidence are not needed. The evidence in your heart, the evidence in your buddhi, the evidence in your experience are good enough to get the improvement. Because the whole world is nothing but in the form of evidence which are confirmed as the experience. Okay, that's what here. Just we go along with the Krishna, not, you know, sticking or hitting the head too much whether it is possible or not. Just this is upasana. Upasana means it's a valid pramanas for meditation. The life can be lived with the system, with the formula which are going to be introduced. Now in the beginning he says, Sarva Bhuta Shayasthitaha Ahamatma. I alone exist in all the heart, means buddhi, as in the form of I. I become the center of every individual system, has got the center point. That center, all those center points becomes one center point. So now it's a kind of, you know, people said, one of my students said, it looks like a 360 degree experience. Then I said, what is this 360 degree experience? So experience are experiences. Okay, so this is, we cannot conclude the degree. We need not to conclude the degree. This is not the song, you know, it's a 3D, 4D effect and 5D effect. And nowadays, you know, 8D effect. I heard in a 12D effect, all those things are 1D is enough. That's mind D, the dimension of the buddhi. The buddhi has got the dimension which it cannot be fixed, the dimension of outside. This is the dimension of inner core. Inner core cannot be fixed with the outside dimension. Therefore, don't take it as the physical experience, physical, you know, giving grossified examples. No need. When you are able to realize that your existence as I, that is beyond the dimension. That is the dimension which becomes the center of other dimension. That's all. So that's what Swamiji, I say this is 360 degree appearance. No. Don't confuse yourself. The Shastra never confuses us. We need not to get confused. And one more thing, the Shastra, when you go along with Guru, along with the people who are informed, you will gain more clarity and you won't also confuse others. Nabuddhi vedam janayet ajnanam karma sanginam. We have to be very careful in that. Shastrajnaha never confuses others. And he himself won't get confused. Okay, that's what the clarity which we require now. He says, I am the center point, means just you sit and think about your center point. You do meditation. This meditation can be done with the posture sitting or while doing work. Brahmanyadhaya karmani sangam tyaktva karoti yaha lipyate na sapapena padma patrami vambhasa. So that was told. So when you work, when you walk, when you talk, when you do anything, you can be focused inside of that Atma. That is the meditation. Aham adihi, aham madhyaha, bhutanam anta eva cha. This is the second line. Aham adihi, aham adihi means, so I become the cause of entire creation. Now this understanding to be understood properly. Because we depend on so many objects outside. Those objects are mortal in nature. We should know the subject which to be depended on or depended upon. So that is the consciousness. We have to depend on the consciousness. We need not to depend on children. We need not to depend on the parents, society, power, money, or any other kind of source out of this external world, because it brings more insecurity to you. Aham Adihi, I am the place of origination of all creation. It means what? I am the Karanakarta, I become the cause. I become the cause means what? I become three kinds of causes that we have seen. You know, the Karya Prapanchaha, Karana Prapanchaha, and the Brahma Swarupaha, of three kinds of causes. The gross cause and intelligent cause, and Vivarta Upadana Karanam, real cause. So three of them are nothing but me. Because the world is created from me, I don't go anywhere to find the material. Therefore, I become the cause and I become the end also. So this can be understood with a small example. The great example is pot. Okay, when the clay was there, pot was not there. Okay, so from clay, pot is created. Now, pot is created, then after destruction of the pot, clay remains. Now, previously, before the creation of the pot, clay was there. Then, during the pot, the existence of the pot, clay remains. After the destruction of the pot, clay continuously remaining. Isn't it? That's what Adihi, Madhyaha, Antaha. For you, pot was created, pot was destructed, but clay alone exists in the form of pot. We use the pot as the understanding it's a pot, but though we understand pot is the other material than the clay, but evident is clay alone continues to be as the pot, giving the benefit for our usage. Therefore what? Adihi, I was the clay, I am the clay being the cause of the pot. Okay, then I continuously to be as a clay after the destruction of the pot even. Like that, world exists now, it was created. Before the creation, I exist. And during the creation, also I exist. And after the destruction, dissolution also, I continuously be. Hence, my existence continuously, it goes on and on and on. Swamiji, what is the benefit we get out of this understanding? My God, God exists all over. And past, present, future, everything, you know, it goes on Him. He continuously exists in the past and present and future. And without any modification, world comes and go. Therefore, what? He becomes a great supporter. We have to take shelter of that subject called God. Therefore, catch hold Him. Only one weapon is bhakti with lots of understanding. That is the understanding we should get from these words. Aham Adihi, Aham Madhyaha, Bhutanam Antaha Evacha. I am the past and present and future. I am the cause of past. I am the cause of present. I am the cause of end. I am the place of past and present and future. I am the cause of all. I remain as the Karana Vastu. This is the understanding by verse number 20. Then we'll go to next verse. Aditya Namaham Vishnuho Jyotisham Ravir Amshuman Marichir Marutam Asmi Nakshatranam Aham Shashi. Now Bhagavan has begun to explain the glory of Paraloka Vibhuti. Paraloka means the world hereafter, the world beyond our understanding. You know, many people, they are not accepting there can be another world. But there are people who even accept there is a devil or shaitan. They don't accept there is the God. So wrong people. The God is to be understood properly as it is explained in the last words. Now here, there is a loka. You need not to break head to find the evidence of that loka. Just go along with Krishna. He says, Adityanam Aham Vishnuhu. So these words, it talks about glory of Paraloka, means you should realize it's beyond our understanding, but I can have a kind of inference. This is knowledge which based on inference from your side. Though the fact remains as the fact, but for us, we don't have the equipments, karanas, to see those loka. Just we accept, Adityanam Aham Vishnuhu. There are 12 Adityas are mentioned in our Shastra. Now, what are the 12 Adityas? That we will see elaborately in the forthcoming section. Now, here, just Vishnu is one among those Aditya. And that Aditya, so what kind of Aditya means? Amshuman Ravihi. He gets connection to this sun deity that we will continue from the next session. That because, you know, Gayatri is completely based on the sun deity. That sun deity is nothing but Ishvara now. The proper evidence is given by Lord Krishna himself in the verse number 21 of the 10th chapter. From these words, every word has to be given or supported by lots of Shraddha. The Shraddha which is to be generated by your effort and responsibility. Then you can feel the fruit. If you have a small bit of doubt, it will take years to accept the fact which Bhagavan Krishna is going to say. We will see and continue from the next session tomorrow. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.